Coming to another epithelial odontogenic tumor, the squamous odontogenic tumor. It is believed to arise from rests of molasses in periodontal ligament. It is a tumor, not a carcinoma, and derived from tissues forming odontogenic apparatus. Bolon et al. First described this tumor. It is known to occur in wide age range from 1st to 8th decade of life. The mean age of occurrence is 38.2 years. It is found more in males than in females. Males to female ratio is 2:1. It is generally asymptomatic. The growth is slow. Occasionally, mobility or displacement of teeth is seen. The tumors arise within the bone. Sometimes squamous odontogenic tumors are also seen in gingiva or buccal mucosa. It is a rare tumor. It is commonly found in anterior maxilla or posterior mandible. The prognosis is good. There are low chances of recurrence and no malignant transformation has been reported. Well-defined unilocular angular radiolucency is seen between roots of adjacent teeth. Sometimes root resorption is also observed. Occasionally, radiopacities are seen. So, it is a well-circumscribed lesion. There is semicircular or triangular radiolucency. This radiolucency is surrounded by sclerotic borders. Very rarely, large and extensive squamous odontogenic tumors are seen. Histopathologically, islands of benign stratified squamous epithelium are seen. There is well-defined fibrous stroma. This tumor may contain keratin or seminoma bodies, and often epithelial vacuolization and microcysts are observed. Generally, there is no ATPR, no mitotic figures, no inflammation, and no peripheral palisading. In this picture, we are seeing islands composed of squamous cells. So, islands of benign squamous epithelium are seen in mature connective tissue stroma. Generally, there are no tall columnar cells and there is little reverse polarization. Keratin pearls, microcysts and intraepithelial calcifications are often observed. Sometimes fibrous condensation or hyalinization is seen around some of the epithelial islands. We have to differentiate this tumor from ameloblastoma, particularly acanthomatous ameloblastoma. The lack of peripheral columnar cells and palisading nuclei establishes the differential diagnosis between the two tumors. So, primary thing is to distinguish it from primary intraosseous squamous cell carcinoma. Coming to peripheral squamous odontogenic tumor, it is rare. It is found in soft tissues. Radiographically, fossilization of underlying bone is seen. This may be due to pressure phenomenon rather than the result of true tumor infiltration. So to summarize, squamous odontogenic tumor composed of islands of cells which contain squamous cells. The mitotic figures are rare and pleomorphism of cells is occasionally seen. There is well-defined fibrous stroma and we have to differentiate it from acanthomatous ameloblastoma. On the basis of number of islands, we can differentiate this tumor from ameloblastoma. In squamous odontogenic tumor, the number of islands is more, but these are smaller in size. Thanks.